The Shizzle Show, STLR, yeah. STLR, you know what I mean? Man, we got some wonderful guests. One in the building that's already here right now, my man Big Business. He's here with us, you know what I mean? We're gonna get it in, chop it up with him. You know what I mean? Then we also got a nice little phone-in conversation we're gonna get from LA, my man Vocab, your boy Vo Williams. One of the first cats that got retired from 106 and Park when it was popping. You know what I mean? That's realness right there. We're gonna get it in with him. Big Business, chillin'. We're gonna get into an interview in just a second. Let's jam for a minute. It's the Shizzle Show, STLR.
It's being serious.
You know what I take this all?
You gotta do that shit for the area. Make the city love you and make the city money, make the city grow, and it just has a moment. You going somewhere else. Hell, if movie stars in California, you gotta bring that shit back to the home.
Motherfuckers that think outside the box and wanna accomplish this shit can't accomplish it here because the opportunity isn't provided for them.
And you're right, but you know what?
You know what I mean?
And
you gotta go to LA to get the LA opportunity.
And that's cool, but it's like there gotta be a homecoming. See, people go and they leave and then they don't come back because they in their feelings about what happened. But you want to be who you are.
What's happening? It's the Shizzle Show. STLR got my man Big Business in the building. Appreciate my bro back there shooting the footage. You know what I'm saying? My co-pilot, Queso, doing our thing, man. Appreciate having brothers in the building. Shizzle, Shizzle. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? That's just one of the arsenal. So let's talk about some of the projects that you put out, bro.
Okay, I'll talk about what I'm doing right now, which is about maybe about three.
Okay, give me that right now then.
Yeah, that right now, I'm not gonna give you what's coming yet.
Okay.
I'll give you right now, right now. Right now I have a show called What's Real Hip Hop. On my YouTube channel, which is Big Business of Hierarchy. My YouTube channel, I bring on different artists, different producers, different people from the music industry, singers, because singing is part of hip-hop. Please don't get it confused. It needs to go back more towards that as well. You know, the Ja Rule and the Shanties, the Mary J's. Yeah, exactly. Because
you know what I mean?
It just makes it, it elevates it to a different level.
Yeah, it was rugged, with no hard, with no like auto-tune.
Right.
Or none of that.
Right, yeah.
The brothers is just...
What about that Mary J. joint?
Yeah, which one?
The one with...
With Meth?
With Meth. Yeah.
See, I liked a lot of that stuff, but I never liked Ja Rule. But I liked a lot of that stuff, though.
Right, and the thing...
X kind of harmonized a little bit back then,
too. Did, yeah. And how many things did that create for him? You know what I'm saying? You can't have a situation where opposites attract. A man is attracted to a woman. And the thing is, when you put two energies together with that collaboration... You put a dude's perspective and a woman singing the hook, man. Think about Jay-Z and, you know, there's countless other people who have done that.
Yeah.
People are scared of it, and then they went to auto-tune. Why are you going to auto-tune? Because you're trying to replace what that used to be, but you want, you know, it all to be about you. That's selfish, man, because you can't sing with an auto-tune as good as some of these female artists out here.
That's real, because even on the R&B joint with it, like, Thugs were even jamming out to My Boo by Usher and Alicia Keys.
All day. That's what I'm saying.
That's that jam.
Yeah.
I was jamming that in